Biblically minded Christians should look at issues falling into one of two categories, the secular and the sacred. True or false? False. There is no distinction for the Christian, according to the Bible, between the secular and the sacred. All issues are religious issues. All issues are spiritual issues. In fact, even Random House Unabridged Dictionary of the English Language defines religion as this, a set of beliefs. How many of you in here have a set of beliefs? You've got a religion. Even the dictionary defines a religion as a set of beliefs. Webster's New World Dictionary defines religion as a system of beliefs. The word belief is defined as opinions and thoughts upon which people base their actions. Since an individual's worldview is the foundation of his or her values, and these values form the basis of their behavior, it's clear that if you're alive and have a collection of beliefs, then you have a religion. And therefore, all issues and all subjects are in some way religious or sacred. But you see what? Secular humanists deny a religious worldview as the foundation of their science, their ethics, their morals, their values, the economic system, law. However, when advocating a religion-free school system, government, and culture, they have ushered the religion of Christianity out the front door while ushering secular humanism in the back door. And yet the Supreme Court has ruled in 1961 that secular humanism is what? A religion. As Christians, you see, it's imperative that we understand that we're fighting a religious and spiritual worldview battle, regardless of what others may claim. In the courts, in the state houses, the U.S. Congress, every issue is a religious issue. You see, when people teach history, or law, or science, economics, sociology, civil government, social issues, they teach in light of their worldview, don't they? Whether they specify it or not, they are teaching based on their beliefs, on their worldview, on their religion. You see, in all cases, a teacher will maintain a perspective that communicates something about every one of these issues. Listen to this. A teacher will communicate something about every one of the following issues. There is absolute truth, or there's not. Man has a free will, or he does not. The end justifies the means, or it does not. People will be held accountable for their own actions, or they will not. God is, or God is not. Mankind can save himself, or he cannot. And individuals are autonomous and not bound by any higher authority or moral law, or they're not. Laws evolve and change, or laws should be based on the Ten Commandments that do not change. Marriage is between one man and one woman, or it could be between two men or two women. All roads lead to God, or there's only one way. The Bible is the authoritative word of God, and it's a reflection of God's character and nature, or it's just a historical work that holds no more authority than any other book. You see, a teacher is going to convey their worldview on these issues one way or the other. Life begins at conception and is sacred and to be protected. Or active euthanasia and abortion are acceptable means of dealing with population control and ending an inconvenience. Parents are responsible to raise their children and inculcate them with their values and their worldview. Or it takes a village to raise a child. Christianity is truth, or Christianity is intolerant. Life has no eternal meaning, or we'll be judged according to how we lived and whether we accepted Christ as our personal Lord and Savior, repented of our sins. Mankind is here by chance, or God created us with a distinct purpose. People are created in the image of God, or are they simply evolved from animals? We're to judge that which is right and wrong, or we should never pass judgment on anyone and accept all ideas and beliefs as equal. No matter what someone is debating, teaching, or discussing on any topic, beliefs, values, ideas, or ethics, that person's worldview will color the discussion, and it will be communicated to the listener or the reader whether they know it or not. And the person intends to convey a worldview or not, whether they intend to convey a worldview or not, they are conveying a worldview, their religion. So is it possible to teach on any subject from a secular standpoint? No. Is it biblical for Christians to divide their worldview from the secular and the sacred?